He was a rock star. He was a fashion icon. He was a business person. He had an amazing personality. He had a magical voice. He was the voice of youth in the 80s. He knew how to win hearts of people. He was a true sensation. His demise left a scar on hearts of many. His memories are precious. Let us talk about his early days. Junaid Jamshed was born in Karachi to Jamshed Akbar, a group captain in the Pakistan Air Force. After graduating from an international boarding high school in Yanbu'l-Bahr in Saudi Arabia, Jamshed wanted to join the Pakistan Air Force to become a fighter pilot. However, his weak eyesight prevented this. He then entered the University of Engineering and Technology in Lahore, where he took mathematics and physics before declaring his major in mechanical engineering. In 1990, Jamshed gained a Bachelor of Science degree, graduating in mechanical engineering. With his father's influence, he was employed by the PAF as a civilian contractor and moved on to a short-lived career in aeronautical engineering in the PAF's Science Command. In 1983, Jamshed started performing rock music at Peshawar University and Islamabad University campuses while still a student at HUT in Lahore. During this time, Rohail Hyatt was in town searching for a singer for the newly formed band, Vital Signs. Bassist Shahzad Hassan and keyboardist Rohail Hyatt arrived at the campus of Peshawar University to meet Jamshed but were unable to do so because of severe winter weather in Peshawar. That night, Jamshed sang Careless Whisper, a 1984 single by George Michael, on the university campus. They would not meet with Jamshed for a further 4 years. In 1987, Jamshed joined his engineering university's rock band, Nuts and Bolts, as a lead vocalist and performed at Flashman's Hotel in Rawalpindi. Junaid Jamshed rose to fame after singing patriotic song Dil Dil Pakistan in the 80s. His music deeply resonated with the youth of the 80s. This beautiful song became the identity of Junaid. He had a voice of his own that carried an infinite hope and sunshine. Even today, almost after 2 decades, they have a huge list of fans, listening to their songs and playing covers. They managed to create relishing and mesmerizing music in a highly Islamized era, where there wasn't any concept of concerts and shows. Vital Signs had euphoria and charisma of their own. They were different individuals with their unique set of traits. After listening to his songs, a cascade of emotions gets revived in our hearts. Pakistani pop music had a different meaning before this patriotic and saccharine pop song. Most of the songs were recorded with lead and backing vocalists in studios. In such traditional times, airing a song with 4 young, energetic and vibrant boys wasn't an easy task. Although the template for modern pop singing in Pakistan was set with Hassan siblings, but the real one came out with Vital Signs. The generation that grew listening to their songs is in 30s today and is in love with the beautiful melodies produced and created by Vital Signs. Junaid enjoyed the same level of success with his solo albums too. Then his life and ideology took a U-turn. He bid adieu to a musical career and moved on to launching his clothing business and got busy in recording nasheeds. Whatever he started, he was searching for peace of mind and soul. He was successful in finding it too. One thing was common in his life. As a musician, he was controversial. When he changed his ways, he became even more controversial. Junaid did not have fans and followers from Pakistan only, but he was admired all over the world by millions of people. Whatever he did and wherever he was, his country was always in his heart. Stepping into the 80s, we capture a sense of our surroundings and the world. Talk about people who inspired us as Pakistanis. Junaid Jamshed was one of them. It takes us to the epoch of vital signs when he gathered colossal recognition and success as a well-celebrated pop artist. We sought him in terms of immense pride as he remained one of the few that flourished our music industry. Being a broadcaster on FM radio for more than 6 years, I have always felt that no patriotic transmission or shows is complete without Song Dil Dil. Vital Signs were trendsetters and pioneers of creating boy bands in Pakistan. After that, a number of bands came in like Junoon, Arid Zone, Yutagan, The Sequencers, Collage, Doll, French Benefits, Nori, Rup, Azan, The Watts, Roxanne, Streams, Mizrab, Caravan, Kayas, Call, Lal, and Entity Paradigm. Junaid was much more of an artist. He was a pure trendsetter. He was a religious scholar, pop star of 80s and a business person too. He created an aura of music that deeply touched the hearts of millions even today. He is gone, but not forgotten. Even after his demise, the enigma that he created would always live forever. His refreshing and nostalgic voice takes us back to the golden 80s. Thousands of people paid him tribute in form of articles, covers and poems. Junaid Jamshed will remain a beaming symbol in our hearts forever. He was a backer and a guiding light of hope for many. He developed a vibrant sense of duty and continued to outshine by his work in all areas he explored. The caravan he started would never stop.